the next step is you want to cut away all of the silver that isn't the bezel cup. You may not be able to see this very well. I've got to put my finger right up on top of it so that I don't. Taking that piercing saw, cut all the way around the bezel cup. So save that silver, put it in your silver box, melt down for later. And the next thing you want to do is to get your Dremel tool or file, essentially file down all the way around that bezel cup. You'll find a diamond burr. Nice big round diamond burr, something like this will do. Okay. Always safety first. And you just want to go all the way around the bezel cup. I'm taking out those saw marks, just making it nice and flat, attractive all the way around. Run it across the top there just to make sure no burrs on it. Alright. So the next process is where we attach the bezel cup to the ring shank. So the first thing you need to do is make it flat. You can do that with your Dremel or bench vise. Sometimes I'll just use a little flat file. Nice flat surface so the bezel cup touches all the way around. Okay, once you have that nice flat surface, find a way to prop your ring up. I use a little pair of tweezers on a stand like this, but there are lots of ways to do it. You can just set it in. What's that? Mind the way. Okay. Put a little bit of solder on it, a little flux on it. Balance the bezel cup up on top. And And for this part, you want to use soft solder. This is the last solder that you'll make, so it doesn't need to. Having it flexible is sometimes really nice because it's hard to get this thing right. You want to balance it. Now if you heat it too quickly here, this thing will want to jump off. So I try to start slowly whenever I'm doing this part. What's that?
Can I want to see if it took a time?
That's okay. I'm going to make it back this way a bit. Sometimes I'll grab my soldering pick and just put a little weight on it while the flux burns off, just to keep it from jumping around. I've got the weight on it. As it heats up, I'll position the Pallion solder right up next to that bezel cup. When it burns and balls up, I'll get up. I'm sure there are a lot of professional jewelers out here that would just cringe my technique, but I'm not professionally trained. I've essentially taught myself how to do this, and so this is the way it works for me every time. So it's nice and balanced there. The solder's run both sides. That's essentially the hard part all done. Now I'd put it in some pickle. Which is this. It's sodium hydrogen sulfate. You just put some of that in some water. And I heat it up in a crock pot or kettle. I used to heat it up in a kettle, crock pot, a lot of different ways to heat it up. And essentially just drop that in the pickle. The tweezers are very hot at that point, so don't brand yourself. And that's essentially all the soldering stuff done. So we'll put up all the soldering stuff and be back with next video on the stone setting.